morning, everyone. Thank you for being here at Springfield High School Library, where we are proud to have this bill signing here this morning. I want to welcome all of our visitors, our distinguished guests here today. It's exciting for me to introduce this process today because this is the high school where I graduated, where the idea of becoming a teacher first formed in my mind as I took my next steps in my college and career experience. And behind me today are some stories and some creative programming that were coming to light because of our teacher shortage in the state of Illinois and across our nation. We want to reinvigorate the idea of becoming a teacher in every student's mind and make sure that we have career pathways and opportunities set forth so that they can take action on that idea. And the bills that are going to be passed today are not only a help to school districts across the state of Illinois, but they are also a way to help each of our students and many of our professionals see a path forward to the classroom. So it is my great honor as Superintendent of Schools in District 186 to introduce Governor Pritzker. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much to Dr. Gill. Thanks for having us here today. And also, I want to say for the work that you and that your Chief Equity Officer, Jamar Scott, and your entire team is doing to renew and improve the student learning experience here in the Springfield District. I also want to thank our legislative hosts and champions for progress that we're making today. Bill sponsors Senator Doris Turner and Representative Sue Scherer, as well as Senator Meg Loughran-Capel, and their many General Assembly colleagues, including our great Senator Bennett, who's sitting in the front row here, and there are many who could not make it today, who were very much involved in getting this legislation through. Senator Christina Passione-Zayas, Representative Dagmara Avelar, and Representative Ann Stava Murray. So thank you all for being champions for parents, for schools, for local school boards, and for putting our children's needs at the forefront. These four bills that I will sign shortly are part of a larger effort that's been underway really for 3 years now to rebuild the ranks of teachers and paraprofessional educators across our state after years of decline. I'm proud that Illinois has added more than 5,600 teachers to the profession this school year alone, which is more than in any single year over the last 5 years combined. And it's the largest single year increase in new teachers on record, since records have been kept. To get here, over the last 3 years, we've raised the minimum teacher salaries in Illinois. We've better funded teacher pensions. We provided $1.2 billion for the evidence-based school funding model. We've made it easier for retired teachers to come back to work, enhanced recruitment and retention programs, and created more flexible routes for licensure. And there's still so much more work to be done to ensure that no classroom goes without an education professional. In Illinois, schools still have more than 2,100 unfilled teaching positions statewide. That includes 15 unfilled teaching slots here in Springfield and 64 in Decatur, with similar need for paraprofessional positions. With new tools, though, and new funding at their disposal, districts all across the state are working to find new ways to bring people into this profession and to encourage them to stay there. Springfield Public Schools has launched an incredible new diverse workforce pipeline program, paying for their teaching assistants and paraprofessionals to become fully licensed classroom teachers. It's an innovative way to use one-time federal learning renewal dollars for a cause that will pay dividends for years to come, and I am very proud to see it come out of our capital city. But here and across Illinois, the state can still do more to make entering, staying, and returning to a classroom more attractive for our educators. In this fight for our children's futures, our districts should know they are far from alone. That's why today I'll sign legislation to reduce the reinstatement fees by 90% for a lapsed educator license. That becomes effective immediately. This will help more than 1,000 teachers re-enter the teaching ranks every year. We'll also allow students currently enrolled in teaching programs who have nearly finished the requirements to graduate to get into the classroom early as substitute teachers. That includes leaders like Haley Schwapak, a recent college graduate and current student teacher at Grant Elementary here in Springfield, who will share her story in just a few moments. We're also tripling the time short-term substitute teachers are allowed to spend in a classroom. Finally, we're dropping the minimum age for paraprofessional educators to help out in K-8 classrooms from 19 years old to 18. Because if a prospective educator has completed all the necessary coursework and training, their age as an adult shouldn't stand in their way. That includes aspiring educator Eleanor Stuckey, an 11th grade student here at Springfield High enrolled in the Teacher Education Pipeline program at Lincoln Land. You'll hear from her as well. To succeed in improving our education system and overcoming years of neglect, we must make sure that we have great teachers in our classrooms, in every classroom. People like Eleanor and Haley serve as the entry point for kids to learn about the world. It's on all of us to show them that we value them, and that includes by making sure that they have enough colleagues to get the job done. I'm very proud that the budget that I signed into law for the coming school year more than doubles the Minority Teacher of Illinois scholarship program, opening doors for more Illinoisans to lead classrooms in the communities they serve, and just $40,000 a year beginning on the first day of school in 2023. Quadruple the previous statutory minimum wage for teachers. That law, combined with proper funding and all the work to remove barriers for qualified people to enter this profession, is increasing the ranks of teachers across our state even now. To teachers in this room and all over the state and potential teachers, I see the hard-earned dollars that you pull from your own pockets to provide school supplies in your classroom. The after-school hours that you spend with students in your classrooms, these goes hungry. And I see you, and I want you to know that we are continuing to find new ways to bring more help into our classrooms so that all students can get the education that they deserve. And now I'm very happy to introduce one of our chief sponsors, Senator Meg Loughran-Capel. Senator?
Thank you. Good afternoon. I'm State Senator Meg Loughran-Capel, and I represent the 49th Senate District. I am honored to be here today to celebrate the signing of House Bills 4246 and 4798. First, thank you to Representative Scheer and Representative Stava Murray for championing these two measures in the House. And thank you, Governor Pritzker, for recognizing the dire need to address the teacher shortage by signing these bills into law. Illinois teachers, support staff, and other school employees are at a breaking point. There was a teacher shortage before the pandemic. As a former special education teacher, I know firsthand the difficulties and that schools and other teachers face when there is not enough qualified teachers or substitutes in a school. Teachers already stress about taking needed time off when they are sick or when a loved one needs looking after. And adding the struggle to find a qualified substitute teacher on top of that, a pool of substitute teachers. Under House Bill 4246, the renewal fees for substitute teachers' licenses will now be reduced to $50 instead of $500. Additionally, House Bill 4798 allows currently enrolled Illinois students in the field of education who have at least 90 credit hours to obtain a substitute teaching license. These new laws will relieve our struggling teachers and open up a whole new group of substitute teachers. Thank you for allowing me to say a few words, and now I'm going to introduce Senator Doris Turner, who is going to speak as well.
Good morning. I am really excited to be here to witness Governor Pritzker signing one of the bills that I sponsored and the others that I was a co-sponsor on. Together, these are going to make a tremendous difference in our educational system, not only in District 186, where I live and went and am a proud graduate of, but throughout the entire state. And this legislation, coupled with the tremendous budget that Governor Pritzker just talked about, will certainly be pay dividends that we'll see many, many years down the road. Long before I served on the Sangamon County Board, the Springfield City Council, or in the Illinois State Senate, I began my community service as a volunteer in my children's elementary schools. And that volunteerism continues to propel me today. I am a huge, huge, huge supporter of public education. My grandmother, several great aunts and cousins were all educators, and I saw the impact that their work had on their students, and quite frankly, the impact their students had on them. Education is the foundation on which community is built, and we owe it to current students and future generations to pour as much into Illinois' educational systems as humanly possible. So next week is Teacher Appreciation Week, and I'll stand here today and every day say, teachers, you are appreciated. COVID had and continues to have a significant impact on all of our lives, and no place has it been more prominent than throughout our educational systems. I'm so proud of the work that we did during this legislative session to assist our teachers in their classrooms, our students, and quite frankly, their parents. Give me parents peace of mind when their children get on that school bus and leave for the day. I would like to recognize several people here today who were extremely helpful to me throughout this process. Erica Austin, who serves on District 186 School Board, Courtney Goss in the Washington Middle School building, and Mardell Daniels, a student here at Springfield High School. So thank you very much. And I'd also like to recognize Jayla Davis, who is a student at Springfield Southeast High School, who serves on my District 48 Youth Roundtable. She's been, has really provided a great spur of the things that we're doing on that roundtable, and always has a lot of really good ideas and information to share. So I am proud of this package of legislation, common sense that keeps kids in the classroom and allows schools more flexibility, and coupled with the significant investment through the budget that Governor Pritzker recently signed, I believe that Illinois' educational foundation is extremely strong and only going to get much better. So with that, I would like to welcome Representative Sushir.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for being here and showing the world how now. And it's heartwarming. The people are kind of like putting their money where their mouth is. So many politicians will say education is important, but then when you get to the backroom deals and time to finalize the budget, it's the first thing cut. So I'm really, really thankful to the governor and to my counterparts in the Senate for carrying these education bills so we can get them across the finish line. I just want to tell you a little story about the bill that started in my office, but it started before that, and it started with a friend of mine who's a retired teacher, who said, you know, Sue, I really didn't think I would away from it for a couple years, and I'm seeing what's happening and how much need there is. I think maybe I would consider subbing. So he says, I go to look into my license and everything, and I thought that I had everything lined up the way it needed to be, and lo and behold, I didn't. And so then he says, so now it's going to cost me $500 just to renew my license that I've had for 30, 40 years. And it makes me question whether I'll sub enough that it'll be worth it or not. And so I'm like, you know what? I think that would be a great bill. And so that is what's sitting on the table over here, and the governor's getting ready to sign. And so now, if you, and I'm speaking to those out there in the media world, if you are a retired teacher and you've let your license go and now you're reconsidering going back into the classroom, it is only $50 now to renew that license instead of $500. So I'm hoping this will draw more back. And that's just one of all these wonderful bills. Another one, and of a session and asked his staff, can we put this on the fast track because we need these subs in these classrooms in May, and here we are, it's only April and it goes into effect immediately. So if you've run out of your days, you're able to maybe help out some in May so that some of these classrooms don't have to go without a substitute teacher. So I really appreciate the fast track on that. So don't ever anybody let you say it can't be done, because it just happened. So thank you so much. This is a very special day for me. I kind of know a lot about that because I was a teacher for a long time, and we're making introduce Dr. Ayala from the Illinois State Board of Education, and we've worked hand in hand on a lot of these things. Dr. Ayala.
Thank you. Good morning. I'm the State Superintendent of Education, Dr. Carmen Ayala, and thank you, Dr. Jennifer Gill, and all of the Springfield District 186 for hosting this today. I'm also excited to have Jayla Davis. She's a member of our Student Advisory Council here today. The Illinois State Board of Education has student advisory members from across the entire state, and Jayla is here, so thank you, Jayla. I also want to thank Representative Avalar and Senator Pasiones Zayas for their sponsorship of the important, enormous strides in growing and elevating the teacher profession, as well as attracting the best and the brightest to this incredible profession. Since Illinois enacted historic funding reform, Governor Pritzker has invested more than $1 billion in evidence-based funding. And in each of those years, our schools have been able to hire more and more. Our schools hired 5,600 teachers, as was mentioned. Last year, we recorded the highest teacher retention rate since we started reporting teacher retention back in 2014. And we saw the biggest jump in teacher salaries thanks to Governor Pritzker and the General Assembly for increasing the minimum teacher salary. This is amazing work, and we as a state have made amazing progress. We still have work to do to ensure that each and every student has well-supported educators in all of their classes. While our statewide teacher vacancy rate has reached a low of simply 1.5%, our schools still have 2,100 unfilled positions across the state. These vacancies are concentrated in hard-to-staff schools and subjects. Our low-income, bilingual, and special education students have the least access to the teachers they need to grow and thrive. We also have a severe shortage of substitute teachers, as was noted, and need an additional 2,400 paraprofessionals to fully meet our students' needs in the classrooms. And that's why the bills that Governor Pritzker is signing today are so important. As we look forward, we must continue to root our efforts to strengthen the teaching profession in equity, because not all schools and not all students are experiencing teacher staffing issues in the same way. We must continue to focus on strengthening the pipeline for special education and bilingual education, supporting equitable funding for our schools with the fewest resources, and building local pipelines of talent and high-need areas. Springfield District 186 has taken this approach and has dedicated $2 million of their federal pandemic relief funds to offer financial assistance for diverse candidates to become teachers in the district. The Illinois State Board of Education has dedicated $5.6 million to provide grants to school districts to implement research-based strategies to improve the retention of their special education teachers. We launched a $4 million grant to recruit more bilingual educators, and we've invested another $5.6 million in state funding for school districts to create career pathways for high school students to get a head start on becoming a teacher. We've directed more than $2 million for school districts to partner with colleges and universities to offer teacher candidates more immersive residencies so they feel better prepared on day one in the classroom. And we've created short-term approvals so that highly qualified industry professionals and career changers can earn their license while teaching. And the list goes on. From teacher mentoring to affinity groups for teachers of color and supports for higher education. As a state, and especially under the leadership of Governor Pritzker, we have prioritized elevating our educators. Our educators are the heartbeat of our state. They keep us moving forward from one generation to the next. They power our future, and I'm honored to be here today to celebrate those new advancements towards strengthening our teaching profession. Thank you. And now I will turn it over to Eleanor Stuckey. She's a high school student who is an aspiring teacher. We'll hear from her.
Good morning. My name is Eleanor Stuckey, and I'm a student here at Springfield High, and I come from a family of educators, which is why I understand so well that being a teacher is no easy task, which has helped become even clearer to me as I see all the things my teachers do day in and day out to help get us back on track and recover from the pandemic. So, as a young person who will be a teacher one day, it is reassuring to know that steps have been taken to make sure that there are opportunities to gain valuable skills through early hands-on experience as I work towards a college degree. Recent bills that passed the General Assembly will make sure that by the time a new teacher reaches the classroom in Illinois, they will have had the opportunity to work with students at both elementary and secondary levels. The SB 3988 bill will lower the age to serve as a paraprofessional to 18 exclusively for elementary education. This legislation will allow me and others to begin working side by side with experienced teachers soon after high school. This will provide us with valuable skills like learning how to keep things interesting for young students and dealing with everyday distractions. Experience like these will not only help us in our future careers, but in our preparation programs, as soon enough we will be serving as student teachers ourselves. The HB 4798 bill will allow an individual applying for a substitute teacher license to be eligible if they are enrolled in an approved educator preparation program in Illinois and have earned at least 90 credit hours. This opportunity will allow people to get additional on-the-ground exposure and experience, such as working with high school students. This will equip us with a wide range of experiences and skills to empower us as new teachers and guarantee success in those initial years. I would now like to hand this over to Haley Schwabach.
Morning. Recently, the Illinois legislature passed a bill that will aid future pre-service teachers tremendously in their journey of pursuing a teacher's certification. It is crucial that we provide systemic supports to to the passionate and talented soon-to-be educators that fill our colleges and universities as we recover from the pandemic. As an inspiring educator myself, I'm grateful to know that our state has taken initiative to provide the opportunity to not only grow academically, but also professionally. I specifically want to highlight HB 4798, which will change the eligibility requirements to apply for a substitute teacher license to allow individuals who have earned at least 90 credit hours to apply. This legislation will grant the opportunity for real class time experience where we can learn classroom management practices, working with students in many different settings, while also making professional connections along the way. These experiences will only strengthen the confidence of future educators as their mindset develops through substitute teaching. This is a step in the right direction. Changes like this will not only help us in our future careers, but also our success, growth, now given that we are supported on our ability to be in the classroom as part of completing our programs. I'd like to bring up Governor Pritzker to sign the bill now.
Thank you, and I'm going to take a few questions before we adjourn.
Governor, I had several teachers reach out even just before you guys came in saying they got fired because they didn't follow the vaccine or testing mandates. How is that not impacting the teachers' shortage?
Well, let's be clear. We are still in a pandemic, and we've been in a pandemic now for more than 2 years. And our schools, as we know, we want to make sure they're staying open, that our schools are keeping everybody in the school healthy. It's very important for people who have leadership positions, teachers especially, who are together with many kids in classrooms all day long, 6 to 8 hours in school together, are vaccinated. And so we've asked them to get vaccinated. We've required them to vax or test. And if they're unwilling to do those things, it seems to me they're unwilling to keep the community of the school safe and the community at large safe.
Governor, DCFS Director Mark Smith has now been held in contempt 9 times for failure to place children in the proper care settings they need. Is it time for him to step down?
So let's just step back for a moment and look at DCFS as a whole. When I came into office, DCFS had been defunded. Republicans had voted against. They'd voted with the prior governor and against funding the agency properly. They continue to do so. And we've nevertheless passed budgets that have helped to increase funding and helped us hire more people. So we have more teachers, more investigators, so that there are fewer cases than there would be per investigator. That and investments in things like the hotline, where we've reduced the number of calls that go unanswered from 50% of those calls going unanswered to 1% of those calls going unanswered. That's just one example of one of the improvements. 500 beds were let go under the prior governor. 500 residential beds. You can't snap your fingers and put those back. It takes years to build back residential beds for these kids. So when kids are having to lag longer than they should in psychiatric hospitals where they may have started out because they have severe mental health challenges, if they have to lag in those facilities while we're getting them a residential bed longer than we like, that's not something any of us likes. But it is something we've been working on steadily to improve about. And yeah, there's a, you know, there are these contempt findings, but understand that each one of the cases, we have actually found residential beds for each of those cases, even though those are literally the most severe cases of psychiatric need.
Governor, we had a guilty verdict, I'm sure you're aware of, in federal court of a former DOC guard for violating the rights of a man he brutally beat. And we saw, I heard several days of testimony from guards saying this is the culture, that we put our hands on inmates. I can't explain it, it's our culture. And we do it in the blind spots where there are no cameras. You've not said anything about this, probably because of the litigation. What have you told the Department of Corrections to do? You know, we had the police reform bill last year. You know, it sounds like the memo didn't get to the correctional system. What are you doing specifically to change that culture and keep these people from violating the oath they take when they leave the academy? And are you putting more cameras into these blind spots?
The most important thing that we've done is hire new senior staff and leadership at DOC and have them carry out precisely the dealing with the challenges that you're raising. So they've been working on adding cameras, they've changed the culture, although there's still work to be done. And all what I can say is, this is tragic. When somebody takes their position of authority in a prison or anywhere else and abuses the people under their care the way that those guards seem to have, those are tragedies that should not occur in our system at all. And it sometimes does take time to weed out the bad apples, but steadily, the leadership at DOC is doing that.
Governor, a budget questions, if possible.
Let me just take one from somebody who hasn't asked a question yet.
Governor, Dr. Fauci announced yesterday that the United States is out of the pandemic phase for right now, and I want to see what Illinois' current stance is. How do you feel the state's doing in terms of
I don't think he said we're out of the pandemic phase, but he did say that the worst of the pandemic phase he thinks is behind us. And I hope and pray that, you know, and I would trust his opinion. I hope and pray that he's accurate in that statement. You know, my view is that we're being vigilant. As you've seen, we no longer have mask requirements across the state. We've lifted many of the executive orders that have had any restrictions associated with them. We're moving toward, I'm hopeful that we will be able to remove all of them eventually, and the disaster declaration. We're listening to the CDC about that and the White House, and also keeping our own counsel about the cases and hospitalizations so that we're tracking it, so that we can notify all of you about the care that you can take for yourselves of your own health.
Would there be another disaster proclamation for May?
Yeah, we're continuing because, again, we're winding down some of those provisions in the disaster proclamation. And that takes a little bit of time. And also, we are still in the pandemic. Let's be clear. The federal government has a disaster declaration in place. So does the state of Illinois.
Governor, two budget questions real quick. Number one, the fuel retailers say they're going to sue over the gas tag sticker. They say it's political speech. Respond to that, and why wasn't there a sticker put on when they doubled the gas tax in 2019? And then secondly, fund sweeps. Chiefs Police Association says they found $5 million of fund sweeps coming from the 911 fund to go to the 988 fund. Can you address that?
Let me start with your question about political speech. Have you read the language that goes on the sticker There's no political speech in there. It doesn't advocate for anybody. It's the same sticker that was put on under the Republican governor 20 years ago when the gas tax was cut. Same exact one. Here's what we're doing. We're lowering the impact on people of the rise in prices of gas all across the world, but lowering the impact for people here in Illinois. Sorry, your second question. I can't speak to it specifically because I haven't looked at that, but I would say that the 988 number that we're establishing, that we're launching, is hugely important. Does take an enormous burden off of our police. These are for mental health calls, essentially, that otherwise you'd end up with a police officer, and sometimes tragedy has resulted from that. And so we want to differentiate between a mental health need that's an emergency and a 911, crime-related emergency that may occur or other major health emergency. I'd be happy to get back to you about the $5 million you're referring to.
This will be the last one, guys. Governor, yes. Carter here. Part one, you and Lieutenant Governor Stratton have been going all over the state. What's the consensus for what you guys think could be the reason for the teacher shortage? And part two, if these bills don't address it, is there a contingency or a plan B for that?
Well, these bills are, again, part of a continuum that has been addressing it. This is not the first time. I mean, Sue Scherer has been fighting for advocating for teachers and for hiring teachers for years. This is not her first time at bat either, and nor the many of the people standing behind me. So there's a lot of work that's gone into this that's helped an awful lot for us to get here in a year when more teachers have been hired than has ever been recorded before. So that's important progress that's been made. As speaking to the problem of why there's a teacher shortage more broad about the challenges over the years, I will just say, though, that this is something we are overcoming. And I'm very proud of the work that's been done. We are in a better place today and on a trajectory, really, to overcome this shortage of 2,100 that are remaining.
Thanks, everyone.
Oh, wait, I'm sorry. I'm just going to let, if you don't mind.
Well, it's probably a very long answer, but for many different reasons. But I think it's just bringing the professional nature back to our career, making sure that we open the eyes of all of our students starting in elementary school about their college and career pipeline and the aspirations that they have for career beyond high school is so important. Important and putting programs in place that will support them, like the ones that we're representing here with Lincoln Land Community College and the University of Illinois at Springfield. Our local universities and our state universities are so important to the work that we do. When they're educated in our state schools, they stay with us in the state of Illinois. When we have great partnership programs between the local school districts and the universities, then we have a great pipeline back for employment. So I think it's just shoring all of those up and making sure that the pathways are open, like the programs that have been signed into law today. So I think it's a very long story, but I think it does start with just raising the professionalism of our career. It's one that's done so well for me and one that I'm such an advocate for public education, as we were just talking about, and then build that into their future. Thank you for having us and using District 186 as a backdrop today. And thank you for all of the work that all of you do that are standing behind me and sitting in front of me to make sure that we're ensuring a great educational path for all students.
Thanks, sir.
Press conference wrapping up. Governor Pritzker and official, more than just a press conference, signing of multiple bills. These are ones that had an impact on addressing the teacher shortage here in Illinois. Brief recap for you. At least three bills signed. One that reduces the reinstatement fee of a lapsed or expired teacher license, effective immediately, but reduces it by 90% from $500 to $50. That was House Bill 4246. Another, House Bill 4798, allows students currently enrolled in qualified statewide educator preparation programs to obtain a substitute teacher license. So this is someone that is working on becoming a certified teacher who could now become a substitute. And that is, again, a qualified educator preparation program with at least 90 credit hours completed. Along those lines, they've reduced the age of paraprofessionals. So dropping the minimum age for paraprofessionals with Senate Bill 3988 to help in K-8 classrooms from 19 to 18 years old. They still have to meet the other qualifications to become a paraprofessional. And then I did hear Governor Pritzker say that there was one other thing done through the signing of bills today, but I didn't catch the specific bill that it is associated with. He noted that they were tripling the time short-term substitute teachers were allowed to spend in the classroom. So all of that happening officially today, of course, these bills having been previously passed through the state's House and Senate. Well, we'll be updating our information on WGNTV.com. So if you're looking for more on this story or wish to share it, be sure to check it out there. Until the next live stream, I'm Chip Brewster. Take care.